Welcome back to Afternoon Express this fabulous Friday afternoon. Now, Rihanna, Christelle and Charles are three friends who set out on a quest to write books for children with heroes that they can really identify with, as well as stories that celebrate the various cultures in our country. So their book, The Blacksmith and the Dragonfly, is fast becoming a favourite in reading rooms all over the country. Welcome to the show.
Thank you very much, Jeannie.
Firstly, congratulations on this book.
Thank you.
Absolutely beautiful. It is interesting. But before we get into it, I want to know, how did the three of you come together to decide to write a book?
That's quite interesting. So Christelle and I actually have been best friends now for almost 12 years. We met in 2007 back in high school. I like to write, she likes to draw, so it just made natural sense. However, we were always in need of a mentor, someone who could give us some guidance.
Yeah.
And that's where we met Charles some years later.
Yeah,
and it's just been
in.
Yeah.
I come from a publishing background, so I've been working in children's books publishing for the last 5 years.
Yeah.
So when I'd moved over, I moved to Germany to just sort of live there for a year or so, and then it asked me to come and help the team out.
Yeah.
Give some advice, help with the writing, and I became co-author of the series.
Amazing.
Yeah.
So there was an idea to write a children's book.
Yes.
Mm. So why this really interested me and what struck a chord with me is I went to art school, and part of my syllabus was ritual and mythology. Mm. And the things that I learned were Greek mythology. I learned about, Roman ritual. And now you've created something written in the, old folklore, I suppose, of Zulu and Xhosa, telling the African story. So was that your intention? How did the idea for this book come about?
Well, there's many things that inspired us to start with this series. One thing, I lived in Germany for 9 months as well, and it's very difficult to tell people about the culture here.
Yeah.
They just don't understand what you're talking about.
Yeah.
So we got this an idea to make stories for people in South Africa by South Africans.
Yeah.
So we realized there's so many cultures and it's not represented, so let's do that. So the first book, The Blacksmith and the Dragonfly, focuses on the Xhosa culture. So everything you see in the book, the characters, there's even some Xhosa words in there. They dress according, the mannerisms are the same as it would be in the Xhosa culture.
You know, I think when kids, you heard about the psychology behind when children watch something like Teletubbies, how they behave to it and how they react towards something like that. And children, like for example, we grew up with Cinderella. How do you think this is going to affect children when their narrative is of their own country? When their story, I suppose, that they read about, their fairy tales are of things that they know of. How do you think that'll impact, like, the next generation of kids?
I think, in the sense, I grew up reading a lot. I'm a big fan of fantasy, I'm a big fan of science fiction.
Mm.
And you never see yourself in that. So that's a problem I had growing up as well. And the moment you do see someone that looks like yourself in it, you just get excited because you feel like that's someone you can relate to. And I think that's what we're working on here, is we want kids to see themselves in stories because, I mean, we all exist in the world and we all are here. So we also have stories and everyone's stories. So I think it's important that everyone gets their story told. Then you see yourself in stories, you see yourself in the media, you see yourself in comic books, you see yourself in movies.
Yeah, that's beautiful. And you are such a talented illustrator.
Thank you.
I mean, I heard that there was so much hard work that went into this. I think it apparently took 3 years to do.
Oh, no.
Two years.
Yeah. Actually, yeah, it took me like a whole year to draw everything.
Really?
I started off with like 15 days for one page. Because I had to get the feel for this thing. Because I just, didn't finish, but I studied 3D animation. But they didn't actually teach me drawing, so I had to study myself. I had to learn everything by myself, so everything was online. So at the beginning, it was like 15 days per page, and then started going a bit faster.
Yeah.
And it's up to now 5 days per page, but it's a lot of work that goes into everything, a lot of research, talking to the community, asking like, is this correct? Do you guys like it? Do you change anything? And yeah, it's a lot of...
So I heard that the research was absolutely insane because everything is historically accurate and tribally accurate, I suppose, as you put it. But the idea was quite interactive as well. So the research that you did apparently was online. And you made people choose what they responded to. So you tell me that story.
No, some was in person as well. So for the Blacksmith and the Dragonfly, we would go to Spur, and approach some families.
Yeah.
It's just maybe not the best thing to do. And if we saw someone in the street, we would just talk to them. And we were also really surprised at how open everyone were to talk about their culture. You know, we first thought it might be a bit annoying if you just walk up to some random person and start talking about culture. But everybody was so open and they really embraced it. And we're working on our second book at the moment that we've codenamed TRC for now.
Yeah.
And for the Prince, Ellen says, we had some designs for the dress, and we had some colors for the dress, and you could vote if, what dress you wanted her to have.
What color one?
Blue.
Blue. Yes, blue. Yeah, I love blue.
So this is Princess Nadalispa from The Blacksmith and the Dragonfly. Wow. Yeah.
That's not the winning dress, I take it.
Oh, no, this is my previous book.
Here's the winning dress.
That is Nolwazi's mother, yeah, so that is a merit to the lady. So you can see how much research we do to make sure that we get the clothing correct as well.
Yeah.
And apart from doing the research, we actually talk to people. We have some polls that we run online. We always invite the community to give us some feedback. We take that in. Like, really, if there's something you don't like, please approach us. We want us to be together with the community we create. It's not just something we want to make and put out there. It must be a collaborative thing with the community.
Exactly. Yeah. Mm. Well, I think it's an absolutely beautiful book. I can't wait for the next one. And I really hope more books like this get put into the curriculums of all the kids studying in South Africa. Thank you so much for being here.
Thank you very much, Jeannie,
for having us. I'll read it out aloud today, considering it's World Read Aloud Day.
Exactly.
Thank you for being here.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.